Hello everyone, good afternoon. Welcome to the WPP learning series. And the topic for today is data visualization using Datorama. Quick introductions. I am Pritesh Bartakke. I am a solution consultant at Miram India. I primarily look at Salesforce Marketing Cloud and Datorama. Today with me here is Amay Narvekar. He is a senior manager of analytics in Datorama. So without spending much time, we'll directly move on to the presentation. So if you've seen the previous slides, presentations that happened here on this WPP learning series, what we saw is that the main challenge that every marketer wants to achieve is that to get the customer from an unknown zone to a known zone. And then finally, when he starts buying your products, you want to start upselling to them. So that is the major challenge that each marketer wants to overcome. And for that, different types of campaigns are run. Now, these campaigns are on various different social platforms, based on various regions, based on brands, etc. So these campaigns, they run everywhere on different channels. And then it becomes a big nightmare to actually analyze each of those campaigns that are running on your different platforms. So that becomes a major challenge, because it's like a fragmented marketing world. I mean, even if you start a marketing campaign on a single platform, eventually when your company starts growing, when your customer base starts growing, what you are going to do is you are going to start targeting all the campaigns on different platforms, on different database engines, and etc. And so it is like extremely important for all your data to actually get combined into a single platform. Now, if you look at this particular slide, there's a initial awareness campaigns to the advocacy campaigns. These are different types of campaigns that they are running on various different platform, that the paid social campaigns, then there are email campaigns, there are e-commerce campaigns, there are website campaigns, there's some data that is available on the POS system, on your offline, online. So all of this data that needs to be measured and understood what exactly is it's working and what exactly is not. So that's the key challenge when you are using a distributed marketing strategies. Your key challenges are understanding what is working and what is not working. What is the contribution to your success or failure from each of those campaigns and each of these activities? Then, based on once you have the data, you want to derive some insights from the activities that have been performed, and then you want to act on those insights and do better planning for all your future needs. So that way, in comes Datorama. Datorama is one platform which will actually help you to achieve all of these, address all of those key challenges by combining all your data sources and giving you a greater insights into your platforms. So this is pretty much the agenda for today. What is Datorama and why should we use Datorama? Whenever we are implementing a Datorama solution, what are the different types of implementation milestones that we have? We'll quickly look at a use case, and then we'll move on to a platform demo before we start off with the Q&A. So what is Datorama and why Datorama? The short answer is Datorama is a marketing intelligence platform. But to honestly, that these three words, marketing intelligence platform, do not do any justice to what exactly Datorama can achieve. So the main advantage of Datorama is that you connect different types of analytics vendors, all your social platforms like Google, Facebook, your DCM, Google Data Studios, Twitter, YouTube, like you name any platform that you can actually market on. I mean, Datorama can now actually connect to TikTok also. I mean, the latest edition was TikTok. So you can add all these different types of analytics vendors via API, or if you have some kind of data that is available in flat files, in CSV files, or some data available directly on your database systems, Datorama can actually connect to all these multiple platforms and get all the data under a single roof, right? So that is the main advantage. And once that data is inside Datorama, there is something called as harmonization, which you can actually use to combine that data, and then you can use that data for further segmentation and granular based reporting. Now inside Datorama, you have something called as Einstein Insights. Now Einstein, if you are on the Salesforce ecosystem, you know that Einstein is the AI bot of Salesforce. And this, because being on AI, this basically runs on the machine learning algorithm. The more data you feed into it, the better insights that it is going to give you. And based on those insights, you can then further measure your ROI. Once you know, and then based on that, you get your understanding as to where exactly which of your segments are performing well, which your campaigns are not performing well, and based on that, you can optimize and change your campaign preferences and investments, etc. And therefore, further you can just optimize the overall performance of the campaign. Once you've done that, you can have the great visualization capabilities of Datorama to visualize and create a story around all your analytics. So that is the the features that are there inside Datorama. It's extremely powerful. The amount of data that it can process in the background, it's extremely high. And it is not. I mean, if you are using multiple analytics platform, like let's say if you are using social platforms and paid social and paid search, you are running campaigns on different platforms. And if you are going to analyze each of them individually, that is actually not going to give you a holistic picture of what exactly your investments and what exactly are your returns. So that is why Datorama will actually combine all of that together. It will use its Einstein bots to give you great insights. You can act on those insights, and then you can create dashboards and see how your trends of campaigns, etc., are working. Now, quickly moving on to the implementation milestone. Whenever we get a Datorama project, what are the steps that we need to follow to actually get from a purchase state to a go live state? So first of all, extremely important is what we do is we do a thorough discovery. That discovery is extremely important in the initial phase to understand what kind of data or what kind of data sources the client actually has. Based on that, we create some mockups. Now these mockups are based on all the data sources that are available with the client that the client is using. We harmonize that data, and that data we create into mockups. That the simple mockups are created, and those mockups are actually shared with the client, and we get approval on that. Once those mockups are done, we actually move on to the solution designing, where it's actually a documentation part where we actually where we get the entire flow of data drawn onto a single flowchart. That helps us in the future, because when large number of data starts coming into Datorama, it becomes a little difficult for us humans to actually manage that data. Then once the solution design is actually approved by everybody, we start with the data integration. So it is not up to 4 or 5 weeks into the project that we start data integration. Once the data for data integration, we connect with all the different types of social platforms that the client is using, and based on that we do the data integration based on the discovery, etc. Post that we move on to the data harmonization. So whatever data harmonization we decided during the discovery and mockups, we continue with the data harmonization, that is like slicing and dicing and combining of different fields within the data. And finally, within the last couple of weeks, we move on to the data visualization, exactly replicating the mockups that we did in the initial stages. So that is the entire implementation milestone. Roughly takes about 10 to 12 weeks based on what are the different types of data sources and the different types of data harmonization that the client is actually looking for. Now, before we actually move on to the platform demo, it's a really interesting demo. I would just want to take up a use case that we recently handled via the Datorama. So this particular client was an Apple retail store. The major challenge for this particular client was that the data was extremely siloed. There was no structure for that data. The large amount of their campaigns were online campaigns, the paid social campaigns, and 95% of their sale was actually through retail stores, the physical retail stores. So there was a complete disconnect between the online campaigns and the offline sales. That was a major challenge. There were huge amounts of data, but that data was extremely siloed. There was no connection. there was no specific naming convention that was being followed by their agencies. I mean, for any new campaign that they were running online or any new schemes that they were running in their stores, there were no specific naming conventions. And like I said, it was there was no connection between offline sales and paid search. So after going through their initial challenges, we actually designed a solution wherein, first of all, we asked them to standardize their naming convention across the POS systems and on their online online campaigns. Then, based on the data sources that they were campaigning on, that they're running campaigns on, we decided on to import 5 API data sources. So which is like Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, LinkedIn, and Google Analytics. And for their store data, that is the offline sales data, we actually did a total connect. So total connect is something that I will go on in too much detail while on the platform demo. But just to understand, the total connect is something which helps us ingest data into Datorama if we are not having an API connection. So that data was on their databases, again, extremely siloed and unstructured data. We actually managed to get that data straight and then import it into Datorama using Total Connect, and finally the Just Dial. So this way, Just Dial data, there's the customer who's inquiring on the Just Dial website, visits, sees some ad on the online platform, and then goes to the store to actually buy a particular Apple item. So that particular linkage we could actually do. So what was the immediate outcome? The immediate outcome was the client, because they were not able to measure any of their return on investment, like because they're investing on the social platforms, but they're not able to link that back to the offline sales. So they immediately started getting insights of the spends of their and their ROI. They immediately started to change their campaign strategy. They started based on their social campaign that they are already running. They directed and targeted their money towards the campaign segments that were performing extremely well. Immediately we could see that the campaign performance was changing drastically towards the positive side. And now, because the iPhone 12 launch is actually scheduled sometime next week, tentatively, of course, sometime next month, they are really excited to use this data and see what kind of outcomes they get during that iPhone 12 launch, right? So quickly, I will move on to the platform demo. Before I start that, I just want to say that the Q&A section is open. You feel free to ask questions, and we'll answer them at the end of this session. All right. So this is the Datorama platform. If you look at the very top, you see the three sections that are there: visualize, analyze, and act, and connect and mix. These are the primary sections that we have to actually look at within the Datorama platform. So first of all, let's go on to connect and mix. Connect and mix is where we actually import data into Marketing Cloud. Now, this is a demo instance that I'm using over here. There are some of the data sources that I've already connected. If you see there, these are all Total Connect. Total Connect, like I said, is something that you can directly connect CSV, upload data into Datorama using CSV files. If you want to add new data sources, you go to Add New. And if you see here, there's a series of like a list of 113 vendors that Datorama can actually connect to. This is like a one or two click connections. So these are all the different types of vendors that are available, like Facebook, Bing, Google Ads, TikTok, LinkedIn, Instagram, Twitter, YouTube, like you name them and they're already here. So all these things are like pre-built into Datorama. So just to show how easy it is, I'm just going to connect one Google Analytics platform, a Google Analytics account. So since Google Analytics, I am going to say Google Analytics WPP. I'm going to say connect to a Google account. While I'm connecting, so I've connected to a generic account that we use, and from that I am going to select a specific account for this demo. future of digital marketing. And I click and I do save. Technically, that's all I need to do. If you look, if you start looking here, this data starts coming in into Datorama. I'm going to say process it in the background. And while the data is coming into Datorama, you see Datorama, you can see it's processing. I'm just going to show you what more different types of connections are possible. So these are all the different types of inbuilt API connectors that are available. Apart from that, you can obviously look at all these flat files, like Excel, CSV files, etc. And you can directly connect to different databases also. Like if you have MySQL and if you have a data view in MySQL and all your data is residing in MySQL, you can just add your database username password and you can add a SQL query and you can schedule that query and all that data will start coming in to Datorama based on this schedule. Now there would be chances or there would be instances where none of these actually work, right? I mean, okay, so if you see this notification here, it says that a smart lenses has been created, and that this indicates that the data that we ingested, the Google analytics that we did, the connection that we did, that is successful. And by default, Datorama has created one dashboard for us from that data. I will look at that dashboard when we move on to the visualization section. So what I was saying is, if none of these marketing vendors inbuilt connectors are actually, you know, meeting your need, then what you can do is you can connect it via Total Connect. A Total Connect is something that is like a catch-all of an email account. So you can upload CSV files, you can upload Excel files, you can upload text files for that matter into Total Connect. Total Connect is Total Connect. Whenever you do a connection via Total Connect, it will give you a unique FTP location and a unique email address. So like for example, if you have a Google Analytics connector, Google Analytics, because it has its own API limits, etc., they will not allow you to query multiple times or like frequent queries to the Google Analytics API will not be possible. So Datorama will sync your data twice a day. But for some reason, if you want some real-time data to be coming in, then you can use Total Connect. So via Total Connect, if you send in the data to an email address or if you send the data to an FTP location, immediately that data will be ingested into the platform. And that data, as soon as the data is in the platform, that data is usable in your visualizations. So for this particular demo, I have all these different types of data sources. These different data sources, like you can see this Google Analytics data source that we just added just now. Apart from that, all these other different data sources I have created. Each data source has its own purpose. I'm not exactly going into the extreme details of all of these, but the naming convention is pretty much straightforward as to what each of that means. And there are some additional data sources which are required to make sure that the data that we are actually ingesting into marketing into the Datorama platform is something that we can actually use immediately. Few more options that are here. There are data load rules. So whenever if you are ingesting some data, if you want to add some filter by default, then you can add those rules within that data load rules section. Data mapping visualizer will actually tell you how each of these data sources, the fields within these data sources are mapping to the Datorama data model. If you look at the few additional sections over here, that is the dimensions. So some of the times when the data is coming in into Datorama, that direct dimension we cannot use many times. We need to do some calculations based on those naming conventions or some fields that are available inside the data sources. So we have to derive some additional dimensions. So for that we use calculated dimensions. And in this particular demo, there are a few calculated dimensions that we have used, and there are some rules and expressions for those calculated dimensions also. Along with that, we have some calculated measurements also. So there are many measurements that Datorama will calculate on its own. Like for example, even if you have CTR information in your data source, Datorama recommends that you should not use that CTR information. Let it calculate on its own. So similarly, there is something called as CPM also, which Datorama calculates on its own. But for this particular demo, we wanted a video CPM, CPM for videos. So that vCPM, that is something that we had to do. And so for that, we use the same formula. If you look at the expression section, it is the same formula for CPM. It is just that instead of impressions, we are actually looking at in-view impressions. So that gives us the vCPM. So that is the way you can actually derive additional measurements and derive additional dimensions within the Datorama platform from the data that is already there. So you don't need to specifically rely on the fields that are present in your platform. Next up, analyze and act app. I'm going to spend some time here because this is one of the very important features inside the Datorama platform. What you see when you go to analyze and act, the first thing that you see here is the marketing insights, Einstein marketing insights that I was speaking about. So this basically works on the AI, Einstein AI, and the more data you feed into it, the more better insights it will give you. Creating an insight is extremely simple. Creating a bot is extremely simple. You just click on the plus icon over there. You select the metric that you want to measure. Like for example, I want to say CPM. Obviously, it has to be decreasing. You select a date range and you do a save and run, and that's all you need to do. And immediately, Einstein will start creating some insights for you. So let's go back. Because it will take some time to actually show those, build those insights based on the data that is already present. What we are going to see is, I've already created some insights for this particular demo. So let's look at this particular insight over here, which is the CTR. So this is, we go inside CTR, and immediately we see a list of insights that Datorama has created for us. If you look on the top, it is first, there are some generic filters for insights, and then there are filters for the custom date ranges. Additional filters, if you want to look at insights for a specific dimension, you can select that dimension here. If you want to look at positive insights or negative insights or both, you can select them over here. And whether you want to, whether you want to see single factor insights or combo insights. Now, again, this is also, I'm going to look at in a little detail a little later. So these are the different types of insights that I have got for CTR. So if you look at this very first insight over here, that is a campaign category video views. It has a thumbs down, which means that it is a negative impact insight. And this particular insight, it also highlights the cause as to why that particular insight is a negative impact. So it says that the volume increased, but the performance has decreased. And if you look at on the little right hand side, it shows that the CTR has actually dropped by 4.75%. So which means, and again, if you look at the last column, it says that the impressions has actually increased by 129%. So which means that my investment has gone up, but I have not got the desired clicks for that particular this particular campaign category. So based on this simple insight, marketers can actually shift their budget and find better ways to invest it, and this will actually improve the overall performance. Now getting into a little details as to what exactly this insight can give, what exact information can this insight give us. So inside this, if you see here, because we are looking at CTR, you are seeing two dimensions, you are seeing two measurements actually, which make up the CTR, that is the clicks and the impressions. And if you see here, the clicks, it says it has gone up by 118%. However, the impressions have also gone up by 129%. So the impressions have gone up, but the clicks, the corresponding clicks have not gone up as much. And this has caused the overall decrease in the CTR. So this insight actually tells us that probably we need to invest less in the video views in category. And that's not just all. If you scroll down, you get a comparison, like a peer comparison for video views campaign category as to how it is performing based on the other campaign categories that are available. So if you hover here, this is the video views. It shows that this is the most impactful negative segment. But next to that, you see LinkClicks, and it shows that it is number one most impactful positive segment. So you know for a fact that LinkClicks campaign category is performing extremely well, and that is how you actually you get a overall comparison. Now this is one of the insights that Datorama provides, and I want to add this insight into the visualization that I'm going to see. So I'm just going to say page pin insight to page, and from the dashboards that I have, there's a summary page. I'm going to say export, and that particular, it says insight exported successfully, and this particular insight will now be available on my dashboard. I'll show you that when we go on to the visualize tab. Again, there are different types of insights that Datorama is going to provide to us. Let us look at another type of insight. This is the CPL, as cost per like. I'm going inside a CPL, and I am going to just sort the positive insights. Okay, and I'm going to look at this particular insight for jewelry and watches with the media by name. So these are the single factor insights that Datorama is providing. If you look at this particular section over here, 38.02, this is the CPL, the cost per like, for this particular media buy. In this particular bar chart, there are different types of media buys that are available, and if you hover over each of them, you will get to see the the CPL for each of those media buy values. And if I just drag this, it actually gives me the entire comparison as to which media buy is actually costing us more for a per like, and which of our media buys are actually performing well. So if I just scroll back, okay, so I'm just going back here. Yeah. Okay. If you look at the right hand side, that is a visualization as to how much of the entire media cost is allocated to this particular media buy. That we are seeing over here. That is for jewelry and watches, right? Now, to further deep dive into this particular insight, we can add additional dimensions to this particular insight and to check what kind of impact those additional dimensions are going to have on that particular insight. So just to add those additional dimensions, I'm just moving back to the CTR insight. I am just looking at accessories, and I'm going to add one additional dimension to this from here, and I'm going to add channel. Right? So now immediately, this particular brand category for the CTR, it says that the CTR for this particular brand category is 95% higher than the average, 95% above the average CTR. And so we are actually looking at what other dimensions are actually impacting this particular impacted this particular CTR. So if you look at this particular channel, if you see here, there are positive and negative impacts, positive and negative insights that we are getting. So if I click on positive and if I click on video, so it tells me that accessories, the brand category accessories for the channel display video, is actually the third highest in my entire entire CTR. And so that gives me a comparison analysis as to how different types of dimensions are going to affect my CTR for this particular brand category. So if I look at some another creative. Okay, let's look at creative format. So here you see that I'm getting a one negative and one positive impact. So which means that this brand category accessories, even though it says that it is 95% above CTR, above the average CTR, but we can still identify where it is still performing less. So if I just go to negative, and if I see learn more, if I click on learn more, so this is the creative format that I'm comparing it against. And if you see, it is probably it is performing below average. So if you see, this is the dotted line over here, that is like the average, and this accessories brand category is performing less, below average, compared in the learn more creative format, compared to, if I look at the positive insight, it is the shop now creative format. And if I see here, so that for that particular creative format, shop now accessories brand category is like the top performing. So I'm getting a 1.76% CTR. And if I just go back to the negative insight, this particular is giving me 0.4% CTR. So you can see that the same brand category of accessories, how it is going to impact, how it is getting impacted by other dimensions, like the creative format, learn more, how it is impacting the performance of the accessories brand category. So once we have this particular insight for the combination of these two dimensions, that is the brand category and the creative format, we can actually look at related insights as to how brand categories, how similar segments are actually performing, and then we can actually go into the details of each of them individually. Okay, so this is the second type of insights, and the third type of insight that Datorama will provide is the combination insights. So if I just go to factor and I say combo insights, and I am just okay, so I'm going to look at this particular living room campaign advertiser living room and the campaign classification as retargeting. So this particular combination, it actually tells us the combination of this particular insight actually tells us the combination of the campaign advertiser living room against the campaign classification of retargeting. Now we want to check whether how each of these are individually performing. So if I'm just going to compare the living room campaign advertiser against all the campaign advertisers, you can see that it is in the center. It is not performing great, nor it is performing poorly. If I look at the other dimension in this particular combination, it is the campaign classification. So again, if you see retargeting, it is slightly below the average. So if you see this dotted line, that is the average of the CTR. This 0.47 is the average CTR. So if you see that the different campaign classifications of direct or prospecting and positioning are either above average or close to average, but retargeting by itself is slightly below average. So based on this, we understand that individually they are not really great performing. So we look at these alternatives. So we go and check the view alternatives buttons, and it will give you the different types of alternatives that can be possible. So if you look at show all campaign advertisers where the campaign classification is retargeting, and in that, if you see the campaign advertiser global is actually performing way above the average. So average is 0.4, and this particular CTR is actually giving us 7.6. So if you combine retargeting with global, then that will actually give you great performance. That is what it's saying. And if you look at the other dimension, which is the campaign advertiser living room, so if you look at living room with retargeting is actually giving you the best possible result. So it says that living room and campaign targeting, based on the entire data that is already available, the living room and retargeting combination will actually work, though it is not something that it is like very close to average, but it is working. So if you look at this, it is like the retargeting CTR, this combination, the CTR is 0.66 compared to the average of 0.19. So if you the idea of this particular insight is that if you look at this first segment over here, So based on that, so based on the campaign classification of retargeting, living room is at number 4. But if you change it to global for the campaign advertising, you are going to be at number 1, and that is going to be your major CTR. So that is the kind of different types of insights that we get. Again, now what I have displayed is probably only the surface of what Datorama can actually do, because obviously I have some demo data and limited data. But otherwise, once your large amounts of data starts coming in, and the machine learning actually kicks in of Datorama, then it is going to give you in detail insight as to what exactly Datorama can achieve. Now again, inside the Analyze and Act, there is something called as goals. So goals is whenever you are looking at insights and you are making some kind of a change, then you want to make that change, you want to make sure that you are reaching that particular goal as to what is your target. So in goals, you actually can create goals. In the goals section, you can create goals wherein there are certain settings that are available. So this particular goal is for the VCPM calculated measurement that I had initially shown, and I have set my goal to be 100 for the entire period, and I have added a green zone, yellow zone, and a red zone. So this particular goal is in the red zone because it is at 122% out of the 100% that we are actually looking at. Now this goal segment can also be a part of our visualization section, because inside visualization, when everybody is looking at what are the different types of charts, etc., that are available, we also want to show the goal chart. Now this goal also has a notification mechanism wherein whenever that goal is reached or it is closing, it is coming close, then you can get a notification on your email, etc. Along with that, inside Analyze and Act, we have reports. Now that the name suggests, reports are going to give you a tabular and Excel format, Excel representation of all your data that is coming in. These reports can also be scheduled. You can select the dimensions, you can select the measurements. Now, Datorama will combine all your different platforms together. The reports can also now have all of these different types of dimensions that are coming from all the platforms. So you can select the dimensions and measurements that you want to actually look at. And then based on that, you can schedule those reports. So now these reports also can be pushed to your FTP. These reports can be set on your email, etc. And then you can actually you can perform some additional actions also. Then there is this query API builder. So this is for the more technical people who actually want to customize their charts. If they want to use some kind of third-party charting solutions for that particular for that particular dashboard, then that API query API builder is helpful to actually get that particular data. And this is the latest addition that happened in the last release of Datorama, is the Tableau connection. So Datorama can now connect to Tableau. So that pretty much covers the Analyze and Act section. And finally, we'll move on to the Visualize section. So if you remember, when we started off this, we actually connected a Google Analytics API account. And as soon as we connected that, without even doing anything, Datorama created a dashboard for us for that particular data source. So this is a Google Analytics specific data source specific chart. And of course, you can not look at the exact data point, because again, this is also a demo account. But if you see this particular chart has been created by Datorama on its own. So even before we harmonize the data, even before we start mapping all those data points together, as soon as the data starts coming in, this particular chart is visible. So immediately you can say goodbye to all your individual Excels or individual platforms that give you data and downloaded that data. And as soon as you connect that data point to Datorama, this data is now visible. So these are the most generic level charts that this Datorama is going to provide. So your major data filtrations are available. So now, because if suppose if like this sorry, this is a data stream filter, and if there are multiple data streams connecting to Google Analytics, then you can add that data stream filter over here. If you want to filter based on traffic sources, so these are the generic filters that are available on this particular page. So if I select device category as desktop, so if you see immediately that entire numbers are reloading, and those numbers will actually change. So if I say tablet, so that is like a quick filter, and immediately you are going to see those numbers are changing. All the charts on this page are going to change based on the filters that you are adding, right? So those are like the generic filters that are available. Again, there's a filter for device browsers. Then on the top, these are all your key indexes, key performance metrics that are the KPIs that you generally want to look at. And if you scroll down, then there are more granular and trend related data. So this is like the traffic trends that are coming in for the month of July. So if you see here, if you can, if you hover you on a particular day, you can see exactly what exactly is the number for that particular day. Then again, these are all the generic charts based on the data that is available. You can obviously, once that data is there, I'm going to show you the another summary dashboard that I have, which will give you the cross-channel information. So if you see traffic by day of the week, all of that, that actually helps you, to run your campaign, etc. Now imagine this particular data being available across campaigns in a single dashboard. So I mean, this if you only have Google Analytics, you might want to go to the Google Analytics platform and then select that particular data and view that data over there in probably the Google Data Studio. But otherwise, if you have like multiple platforms that you are actually running the campaigns on, in that case, that's all of this data is now available within the same dashboard. And then this basically helps you create, take better decisions and create good campaigns based on this particular information. Again, traffic sources. So this particular section was on about the generic traffic. These are the, based on the specific traffic sources that we are getting from different places. So like you see here, Facebook, LinkedIn. So these are different types of charts that Datorama is going to create for us for different. So like this is Google Analytics. So these are like these charts are specific to Google Analytics. When you connect a Facebook account or you connect a Twitter account, then the charts are going to be totally different. And those charts are actually going to be specific to the data that is coming in from Facebook or Twitter or any other social platforms. So that is how the smart lenses work. And before you even actually start harmonizing the data, this data is already available to you, and the users can actually start looking at this data while you work in the background to actually derive additional information. So this is the smart lens. This got like I said, this got created automatically. And then I have another summary dashboard that I'm going to showcase. So this is a cross-platform dashboard. So this combines all the data from all the data sources that were available, like in the first page, the connect and mix page. These are the all the this data is for all the data sources combined. So if you look at this again on the top there, these are the main KPIs that are available. Again, like all the KPIs are obviously not available in all the data sources, but based on the settings and based on the filters that we added, all these different types of KPIs are available on the front. Again, now these are the best performing campaigns and the marketing performance by channel. So this basically gives you a comparison about the media cost, the cost per click, and the CTR. That gives you an idea as to how much you're investing and how much is the returns. One thing that I actually wanted to show in this particular chart. So this particular section, this is from the Einstein bot. So we were looking at the video views insight, and from there we wanted to highlight that this particular campaign category has got a substantial decrease in the overall CTR between these two particular dates. And so that everybody who is visualizing, who's on this, but on these dashboards can actually, take a note of this. So, typically what will happen is all your dashboards are going to be access specific, so that the CMO of the company is going to look at some specific KPIs, and your marketer or your salesperson is going to look at some specific KPIs. So your agency probably is going to look at some specific data points. So based on all of these things, whoever is responsible for this particular video views campaign on their dashboard, you can add this particular insight information. So all of this, the point being that even the insight, they don't need to be hidden inside the Datorama platform. They can very well be in your visualization section also. So again, different types of KPI, different types of measurement, different types of charts that are available inside this Datorama platform. This is a summary based on the demo data that I have. This particular gives us a summary. Then quickly moving on to the demo dashboard. We just have 9 minutes. So this is like a demo dashboard. This particular dashboard, the idea of this particular dashboard was to show how the cash cross channel summary is working. So this particular dashboard has data from Facebook, Google, Google Analytics, Google Ads, Google Data Studios, Google DBM, DCM, IAS, and finally Total Connect. So all of that data combined is actually giving us this particular insight. And one last thing, how do you actually edit the information that is available? So I'm just going to quickly show you this. So if you look at this smart lenses dashboard that is automatically created by Datorama, if you look at this particular section over here, is average time on site, which is like it shows as 112 seconds, but 112 seconds is not exactly a good measure for a human readable, human readable dashboard. So if you can just go here, and if you see from the type that you want to see, is you select the duration, and immediately it changes to 1 minute 52 seconds. So that's how easy it is to change how you visualize that data. So once you do all the hard work for while connecting the data, once you have done all that hard work, then you move on to the data harmonization, and then once that data starts coming in, data visualization, building up the visualization is fairly simple. And that is why milestone, I showcased that milestone slide, that it is extremely important to actually go through the correct discovery and correct mock-ups and solution designing. Otherwise, if your client is going to come back during the visualization phase, during the building of the charts phase, that if they want to look at additional dimensions or additional KPIs, then you have to go back to step one, and then you have to redo the entire thing, and that can probably affect your existing build that is already there. So that is why that slide was important, which says that those implementation milestones have to be clearly defined. So that was a platform demo that I actually had to show. So we can actually. Yep. Move to the questions section. So I am just going to the Q&A. Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to read out the questions and I'm going to answer them. So the question number one, can we also see sales data? Like we ran 10 campaigns, how much sales was triggered by each of those campaigns? Of course. Each and every type of metrics is possible within Datorama. So you have sales data, sales marketing data, everything is possible. Now it also depends, like I gave you that example about the use case. It's also important how your data is actually linked, like how your campaign and how your sales are actually linked together. If you're already following a naming convention, then it is like a inbuilt link. If you're not following a naming convention, then additional steps are required. But yes, it is definitely possible. And definitely possible to get that sales data, and on a very granular level per campaign, per region, if the campaigns are running in a specific in the specific region or specific geographies, etc. So yes, sales data is very much possible. Of course, I mean, if you have a sales representatives also doing that particular sales, probably on an offline sales POS system, then you can have that sales reps performance also within that Datorama platform. So like a showcase for top five performing sales reps, and that dashboard can be visible to everybody. So yeah, so all types of data is available. How is category competition data available? I'm not exactly sure I follow this question, but all of that data is available in the source of your the different database platforms. For example, let's say if you have something called as a product code in your campaign that is running on Facebook, and that product code probably is, let's say, IP12. So now this is not exactly a good product code. So we need the visible name for this particular code or product code that is going to be iPhone 12. So that classification file is also uploaded. That classification is basically a map between the product code and the display names, etc. So those classification files are also uploaded during the implementation. And from there, we get additional information which is not directly available via the sources. So I'm not sure if I understood the question correctly, but from my understanding, I have given the answer. If that is not what you meant, please feel free to ask again. Okay, can we use D3JS charts, which is the third-party charting solution? Oh yes, we can definitely use different charting solutions within the Datorama platform itself. So there is this. So there are large number of charts that Datorama will give by default, but there are different third-party charts like Google charts or Fusion charts, etc. All of those charts which run on JS. Most of these charts obviously run on JS. All those charts are actually possible. All you have to do is you have to just select the dimensions, correct measure dimensions and measurements. So there's a query language which is like a click. So all the dimensions that are available that are mapped, those will be available in the API format in that particular custom section. And you can just, all you have to do is import that library and you can pass that data, and that particular section will be available. Just give me a second. Okay. Yeah, so yeah, third-party charting solutions are also possible. If I can just quickly, after these questions, I will show you some of the charts that are actually developed using the third-party charting solutions. How to get certified in Datorama? Datorama, inside the, once you have access to the platform, you have the some certification that are already available within the Datorama University. You can do those certifications, and apart from that, there are boot camps that Salesforce runs periodically. So if you are a Salesforce partner, those you'll be included into those particular boot camps. And so that boot camp is like a 5-day training, and at the end of the training, you are expected to do a simulation, which is like a live implementation of Datorama. You have to communicate like how you actually communicate with a live client with the Datorama training team. And then you build that, those charts, and they verify those charts, and then based on that you get certified. So yeah, so that bootcamp is something that you can watch out for, and that is how you get certified. What if there is some unique data source, not from the standard system, maybe some new ad network or some legacy ERP system? How does that come into Datorama? There are several ways that data can come in. If you are having a CSV file, and if you upload that CSV file into a Google Drive sheet, you can directly connect your Google Drive, and that data will start coming in into Datorama. If you have that in a legacy ERP system, if you have a database access or a data view access, then you can connect from Datorama. You can connect to that particular MySQL or Postgre or AWS for that matter, and you can connect to those databases, and data can come into Datorama. If you have none of these things, if you don't have access, but you have, if you have CSV files, And if you want frequent data to be ingested into Datorama, then you can use the Total Connect, which is like the one solution for all kind of a system. And inside Total Connect, you can import that data and you can schedule that data. You can either schedule the data or you can just put that data file on a FTP location or on a or you can just email it to that particular unique email address. So whenever a new data Total Connect data source is created, a unique FTP location and a unique email address is created for that particular data source. So once you email it to that, immediately the data is available. So those API vendors that are already there, those are like the easy one-click solutions, and those are constantly increasing. Okay, until last week, I think there were 108 vendors. Today there are 113. So all these, you know, whenever there are new ad networks coming in, all these things are definitely going to be, imported into the Datorama. So more and more API connections will be available, and if you don't have, you always have Total Connect. So what is the difference between Datorama, Tableau, and Analytics Builder in SFMC? Datorama is again like if I give you a very broad explanation about that, Datorama is more about visualizations. Tableau is more about analysis. So it's Tableau is far more Tableau is far more on a technical side. Datorama is more on the marketer side. And Analytics Builder in SFMC, again, SFMC is a platform specific for marketing sends like emails and SMS and ads to ads, etc. So inside Analytics Builder, you'll obviously get information about SFMC Marketing Cloud related on data points only. But of course, Marketing Cloud can be connected to Datorama because they're in the same Salesforce ecosystem. Marketing Cloud can directly connect to Datorama, and that data can come into Datorama, and you can derive additional insights from that also. So that's the kind of difference that I can probably think of. Is FB impression cost data integrated? Yes, FB impressions and cost media cost and FB impression data is very much integrated. So there are two types of connections that are available in the API. So most of the time we recommend that you go via the default connector. So there is I don't know if you remember, but when I was showing those list of different types of API connectors, there was one called as FB ads, and there was one called as FB ads custom. So FB ads is something that will connect the most common data points that are available from Facebook and import it. But if that is not satisfying your needs, then you can use the FB connect custom FB ads custom source. Is exactly same steps, but on that you have to select the dimension and measurement that you want to pull into Datorama. So that's like if you look at Google Analytics. Google Analytics will, by default allow nine dimensions and seven measurements to be imported into Datorama with the by default connector. But if you want some additional information, that information can be pulled into Datorama via the custom connector. So it's like a Google Analytics custom. So the connector is like an API connector. It's only thing that you have to specify the dimension and measurement that you want to import. So yeah, can we use Tableau features over the data populated in Datorama? Very honestly, I do not have an exact answer to this particular question, because this Tableau connector, I think, has been added very recently, and I have not really got a chance to go into deep dive. But if you can just email me this particular question. My email address is there at the end of this particular presentation. You can just email me, and then I'll look into it, and then we can, I can answer that question to you. So I don't see any more questions. These are the upcoming sessions that are coming up in the future. That is the first on the 1st of September and the 8th of September, And along with that, this is my email address here. So if you have any questions, if you have suggestions, and if you have feedback, please feel free to email me. Thank you everybody for joining the session today. I hope it was helpful, and see you for all the other sessions as well. Thank you very much.